And welcome back to The Angry Teacher. I am Richard Williams, The Angry Teacher. Today we're going to be talking about why I have my kids keep binders. Hang around, we're going to learn today. Now, the purpose for my having kids keep a binder for my class is, or a portfolio, if you will. There are like three purposes why I have them do that. It teaches them organization and responsibility. I tell them what to put in there and how to put it, and I check it. I give them a grade every now and then so that they'll be able to be focused on their organizational skills. When they grow up, they're going to have multiple things going on at one time, so they need to know how to organize all of that in one space. All right. The second purpose I have them do it is for them to have their materials at ready when I need them. So reach for such and such handout, reach for such and such handbook, reach for such and such the notes that we took 4 weeks ago. I need you to find it so we can do this situation today. That is one of the reasons why binders to me are important. And also it has them take ownership of their learning. They can see from when they began with me and see how poorly or how well they did, and have they started falling off, or are they doing better now. They can meter and monitor their own success in my class, and so they can it formulates something in their brain, so when they get older in life they can do the same thing. So those are the three purposes I have my kids keep binders. What's in this mysterious binder, you ask? Well, there are a couple of things. It's like basically everything. It's hard for them to lose this because it's everything that they need for my class. In the beginning, in the front, and I should have one to show you, but we haven't been in the building for me to use some of their binders. But we have vocabulary words and some different types of vocabulary that we'll use in English realm. I have them keep that in the front so they can always find it. We have the English handouts. We have a calendar that I give them per month so they know when exams are coming up, when the different clubs meet, when whatever is going on, you know how a calendar works. They have a study pages. They have home learning and study pages, so I can know even after you've taken a picture of the Promethean, the PowerPoint, I know that you have started doing the work. I know that you're studying. I see your note cards. I see your annotation of whatever we just read. So I have a section for that. There's also their notes, their assignments, you know, a combination of all. I don't have them do it by dates. I see some teachers do it by dates. That's way too confusing for me. Just put all the assignments in one place. Once you've written the date on the assignment, I'll find what I'm looking for. You'll find what you're looking for. So just keep all the assignments together, and I think that's it. Projects like index cards that fits in there when you've done those little newspaper projects, or something that you've clipped, you know, the simplicity of the project. And check out the video, project-based learning. You keep that in your binder, and you have that for the whole year. You walk around with that. You don't have to worry about a textbook, you know, because I provide a lot of stuff. So it all goes in the binder, and that's what's in it. By all means, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and ring the little notification bell for the next Angry Teacher video. You know it gonna be dope. How do I grade this humongous binder? Well, here's what I do. I give them a rubric at the not the beginning of the year, but at the beginning of the period. It takes me about a week. I tell them, you have a week to fix your binder and get it to me. I do it 4 times a year. First grading period, second grading period, a third grading period, fourth grading period. So you get 4 huge project grades. It's a project grade as well, because it is a project. It's a working document, a working project. And I give you a grade for your starting to develop your sense of organization. So I give them a rubric in the beginning of the week or the week prior so they can fix and get their stuff organized while they're working on it throughout the year, the grading period, and there's stuff everywhere. I have you, here's the rubric, these are all the things I'm looking for. If you need a rubric, by the way, let me know and I'll hook you up in the comments below, let me know. All right, so I give them this rubric, and so they can look and see what I will be looking for. And when they turn it in, I check off what they have, and that's simply how I grade it. Now, what's on this rubric? I check for, well, for the binder, I check for neatness and their organization, obviously. I check for the different sections that I just mentioned earlier, and I check for their usage of it. Have they been using the binder? Do you see where they have some sticky notes or some things where, like, I will accept a couple of things out of place because it shows that they were actually studying or they were reading, or when they were writing, they were using their vocabulary. So the vocabulary is in the section with assignments by accident or whatever. So, and I look at the binder. If it's a really new binder in the third grading period, second semester, y'all ain't using that. Y'all just bought that binder. I know what's going on. So that's what I'm checking for when I'm grading it. And normally these are really easy grades. It's not that intense. It sounds intense while we're working. It sounds intense, but when I'm grading it, it's the easiest thing ever. All right, you flip a couple of pages, it looks like they're organized. And by the same token, if they've done something and they've gotten an A on the first or and second binder checks, then the third and the fourth, I don't have to do the same thing again. They're literally getting the same grade that they got for the first and second because they have seen their binder twice already and they know by now how to be organized. So that, those are my tips on why I have my kids keep a binder and how I grade them and what's in them. So let me know if you do anything else with your student portfolios and your student binders. All right. Thanks for coming to class today. As usual, I need you to go out there and be great. Hey, let's go out there and teach.